Cuts and wounds are quite common among all age groups. Kids get hurt while playing. Adults might get hurt while cooking, gardening, and other chores. And elders are usually accident prone. Minor wounds can be easily healed at home, about which we will now discuss. Welcome to Arogya Vidya, your guide to feel, heal, and nourish. Subscribe and turn on the notifications to my channel so you don't miss any of my future videos. Without any delay, let's get started. Before we apply any remedy to heal a wound, we first need to stop the bleeding. For that, first tie a cloth 1 or 2 inches above the wound to restrict some of the blood flow. Then apply some turmeric powder on it and it should stop the bleeding in a while. This is a remedy used by most homemakers when they cut themselves while chopping vegetables. Applying turmeric powder heals the cuts without scarring. According to Ayurveda, there's one other method to stop the bleeding. For that, take some oak gall and burn that till it becomes charcoal. Crush it using a mortar and pestle to get a fine powder and apply this on the wound. In India, grocery stores, malls, and herbal medicine shops sell oak gall. This is also available online. After we stop the bleeding and clean the wounds, we can then proceed with any of the following remedies. Remedy 1. For any wound or cut, use the juice of the leaves of Tridax daisy. It is also called coat buttons. This plant has thick, juicy leaves which grow wild everywhere, particularly in rainy season and places where the soil is moist. To get its juice, simply crush the leaves on your palms using your thumb. Apply this juice to the cut. Mild burning sensation will be experienced. Do this twice a day. Within 3 to 4 days, the wound will heal without leaving behind any scars and the new skin will grow. After applying the juice, keep the wound away from water. If that area becomes wet, pat it dry using some cotton. For old wounds with pus, remove the pus and then apply the juice. This remedy can also be used for internal injuries where the affected area is bluish green in color along with some pain. Apply this till the pain disappears and the skin color is restored. No need for any anti-tetanus injection as the juice is very effective. Remedy 2. Take the leaves of palsuthi plant, grind it to a paste without adding water. Apply the paste on the wound and tie a bandage around it. Applying once is sufficient. Avoid wetting the wound. After the wound heals, apply coconut oil till the skin color is restored to normal. This plant is also called Vedikai Chedi. Both are Tamil names and there seems to be no Wikipedia page on this plant. Children play with the seeds of this plant by popping it on their forehead. This plant grows wild in wet soil. Remedy 3. When banana flower is plucked, it secretes a kind of milk. Apply a thick layer of this milk on the wound. This will form a protective waterproof layer around the wound. The layer formed by the milk will shed once the wound heals. Remedy 4. Apply the milk from raw jackfruit on the wound. Once the wound heals, apply sesame, that is gingerly oil, so there are no scars left behind. Remedy 5. For minor cuts, scratches and wounds, either apply coffee powder without chicory or a bandage soaked in sesame oil. Do not use instant coffee powder. You can also apply saliva on the wound. This will prevent infection and help in healing. You must have wondered why animals lick their wounds. Now you know why. Lastly, when help is far off and may take some time, apply few drops of urine or tie urine-soaked bandage around the wound. The regional and botanical names for the herbs discussed in the video are provided in the description box below. If you found this video helpful, do like, share and leave your feedback in the comments below. Let's meet again with another video. Till then, goodbye.